Did you know that 2020 was the global year for the prevention of pain? The International Association for the Study of Pain, IASP, selects a topic each year to raise international awareness of pain. The focus for 2020 campaign was on disseminating pain prevention strategies to researchers, clinicians, and patients. This past year, there were many events organized by IASP and lots of scientific papers published on this topic. I attended the webinars, read the papers, and there were so many things that I learned about that we can do to prevent pain, especially how to prevent that acute pain becomes chronic pain. In this video, I will summarize 30 points that I learned this year. You can access all of these materials on the website of the IASP. I will summarize here 30 ways to prevent chronic pain that are relevant to the general public, patients, and their caregivers. The IASP website also contains lots of additional materials for clinicians, researchers, and policymakers. So, let's learn a few things about chronic pain. How does acute pain transition to chronic pain? There are various biological factors like the extension of the injury, the condition of the tissues and organs affected, problems with posture, muscle imbalances, allergies, ongoing diseases, congenital diseases, nutritional deficiencies, inadequate sleep. There are also many psychological and environmental factors that may include things like mood, social isolation, abuse, trauma, and others. Any of these factors can contribute to the initiation of acute pain and allow for the transition into chronic pain. As these conditions persist, the pain may change or remain constant. And it's thought that around 3 months of persistent pain, the changes in the central nervous system begin to occur. These changes involve rewiring of the neural pathways to compensate for the ongoing pain, and there are brain changes. As this occurs, even if the local site of pain has healed or is treated, the rewired central nervous system could enable the experience of pain to continue, which means the pain is becoming chronic. Once the pain becomes chronic, it's much more difficult to treat, and this may be because reversing the rewiring of the central nervous system is more difficult than improving the original site of pain. How to avoid debilitating chronic pain? Well, the 30 points that I will summarize here are divided into 3 categories. 9 points are related to your general health. These are things that you can do even before you have pain to avoid pain from happening in your life. However, acute pain is unavoidable. And there are 8 points related to how you manage acute pain. And these points will help you to prevent that the acute pain becomes chronic. And the last 13 points are for people who are starting to have chronic pain and what they can do to avoid it from becoming really debilitating and interfering with their enjoyment of life. Please share this video. There is a share button below to send this video to anyone you know who needs to hear this message. If you go to the description of this video below, you will find lots of resources and links that I posted there for you to get additional information. So, let's see the first 9 points. The first 9 points are about general health. These are ways that you can prevent pain from happening in your life. Number 1, maintain a healthy diet. Reduce inflammation to help protect your body from oxidant damage. Polyphenols are compounds found in fruits and vegetables and have antioxidants and anti-inflammatory properties. Good quality fats, omega-3 fats, olive oil, both help to reduce inflammation and enhance the immune system. Prevent vitamin and mineral deficiencies. Common micronutrient deficiencies in people experiencing pain include vitamin D, vitamin B12, and magnesium. Water intake. Dehydration can increase sensitivity to pain. It can also have other effects on health outcomes, especially in older populations, such as poor wound healing and constipation. Increase fiber. Fiber is important for proper digestion and maintenance of a healthy microbiome and weight management. Reduce and limit ultra-processed foods and sugar intake. These foods and drinks contain high amount of energy and very low or no amount of beneficial nutrients. These foods can also increase inflammation and oxidation, which can worsen pain experience. Number two, maintain a healthy weight. Body mass index, or BMI, is a measure of body fat based on height and weight that applies to adult men and women. BMI is a person's weight in kilograms divided by the square of the height in meters. So if a person weighs 70 kilograms and measures 1 meter 70 centimeters, you divide 70 by their height in meters, 1.7 equals 4.41. Then you divide again by 1.7 equals 24. These are the BMI categories, and 24 is normal weight according to the BMI category. And number three, exercise regularly. Exercise regularly. Physical activity and exercise have broad health benefits due to their effects on the musculoskeletal, cardiovascular, and central nerve system. Physical activity is any bodily movement. Exercise is a planned, structured, and repetitive bodily movement that is performed to improve or maintain one or more components for physical fitness. Physical activity and exercises are also considered as strategies to improve mental health, which is frequently associated with chronic pain. Number four, eliminate unhealthy practices like excessive alcohol. In Canada, the low-risk drinking guidelines say that for women, 10 drinks a week with no more than 2 drinks a day most days, and for men, it's 15 drinks a week with no more than 3 drinks a day most days. What does a drink mean? For beverages containing 5% alcohol, like beer and coolers, a drink is about 12 ounces or 341 milliliters. For drinks containing 12% alcohol, like wine, a drink means 5 ounces or 142 mls. And drinking containing 40% alcohol, like gin and rum, a drink means 1.5 ounces or 43 mls. Number five, eliminate smoking. 1 in 3 patients that I treat with chronic pain smoke. We know that nicotine is a painkiller, but it's very addictive, and the other substances in the cigarette are very harmful to the body and cause chronic pain. So it's very important to quit smoking if you want to avoid future problems with chronic pain. Number six, work and rest in healthy posture. We spend 1/3 of our lives working. So working posture, we call this ergonomics, is very important. It's also important to pay attention how we rest from our normal work. So if your work involves sitting in front of a computer the whole day, you need to stand up and do some stretches. If your work involves being on your feet, carrying and lifting weights the whole day, you need to take breaks where you can relax the tension in your muscles and relax your mind. Number seven, cultivate healthy sleep habits. This is so important, I can't stress enough. If you want to avoid problems with pain, start taking care of your sleep quality now. First, you may download some sleep questionnaires from the internet and find out if you have a sleep problem. If you do, talk to your doctor. Then, you may download some apps to your smartphone and monitor your sleep. You'll be surprised how poor the quality of your sleep is. In the description of this video below, you'll find some links to a document that I prepared that summarizes some things you can do to improve your sleep, like sleep hygiene. Number eight. Manage stress in your life. First, recognize that stress is part of our lives. Then identify situations that are more stressful and recognize how they affect your pain or your life. Start practicing body awareness, like body scanning, and record it in a diary. Practice breathing exercises when you notice your stress levels are higher. And you can start with breathing for awareness, then breathing for releasing tension, and then for symptom control. If you keep practicing, you may start with other techniques like progressive relaxation, meditation, visualization, and self-hypnosis. Number nine, seek counsel or mind-body therapist whenever needed. Mental health problems are very common, and people with mental health disorders are more susceptible to develop chronic pain. Things like depression, anxiety, panic attacks, post-traumatic stress disorders or PTSD, insomnia, substance use disorders, and personality disorders. Some people need help from a professional mental health worker to help them treat these conditions. Don't be afraid to seek a psychologist or a psychiatrist and get professional help for these problems. Don't think that these problems will go away with time. In fact, the longer you wait to start treating them, the harder it is for them to be eliminated. We know acute pain is inevitable in life. We can get hurt in an accident or get a disease that causes pain. So the next 8 points are related to how to manage acute pain. Number 10, medications. Over-the-counter or OTC medications like non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, NSAIDs, or analgesics. Talk to your pharmacist about your options, interactions with other medications, common side effects, and for how long you should be taking them. Number 11, applies ice or heat to affected areas. Some people prefer ice for acute swelling, inflammation, or sports injury. Some people prefer heat for muscle aches, muscle tension, and relaxation. Be careful when you apply ice to the area. Use a fabric to protect the skin. And also, if you're using a heating pad, don't sleep on it. I've seen many burns caused by heating pads that were left on during the night and burned the patient's skin. Number 12, engage with physical activity or movement. Number 13, receive manual therapies. Some examples are massage, manipulation, and mobilizations. Number 14, manage your stress levels. Number 15, seek some mind-body therapies when indicated. You may find a mental health provider that offers cognitive behavior therapy or acceptance and commitment therapy. Number 16, check with your doctor if there are other prescription medications that you can take. And number 17, don't forget, eat a low inflammatory diet, rich in fruits, vegetables, nuts, and lean proteins. Get rid of processed foods, sugars, pops, and stay away from smoke, from cigarettes, or smoke from cannabis. Now, how to prevent worsening of chronic pain? Number 18 is about understanding that chronic pain is common and often difficult to completely cure. Number 19, start building your toolbox of self-management tools. Multimodal treatments are best and include the 5 M's that I always explain: modalities, movement, mind-body, manual therapies, and medications. Continue engaging in movement-based activities, including mild to moderate exercises. Number 20, take over-the-counter or OTC medications that do not need a prescription. Some examples are non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs or NSAIDs. Number 21, apply modalities like cold and heat. They also work for chronic pain. Number 22, try alternative modalities like complementary non-drug therapies. This might include acupuncture, massage, water-based therapies. Number 23, have a positive and realistic expectation for treatments. Number 24, find a doctor and a supportive healthcare professional that you trust. Number 25, seek medical advice from a pain specialist or a pain clinic. If one is available in your area, ask if the clinic has interprofessional team. This might include physicians, nurses, pharmacists, psychologists, physiotherapists, and occupational therapists. Number 26, ask about nerve blocks, injections, and steroids if they are indicated for your pain. Number 27, consider other prescription medications like antidepressants, anti-epileptic, steroids, and topical creams. Number 28, begin seeing a physiotherapist, ideally someone who works with a pain clinic and understands chronic pain. 29, receive mind-body therapies, ideally from a trained psychologist. And finally, number 30, if opioids are indicated for pain after a risk assessment is performed, have a plan with your doctor, review the risks and benefits, and ensure that you are taking the medication only as prescribed, with specific and realistic goals determined by you and your doctor. So I hope you enjoyed this summary of a year-long campaign to increase awareness about how to prevent chronic pain and to stimulate some discussion among clinicians, educators, scientists, patients, caregivers, and policymakers around this very important topic. If you like this video, give your thumbs up below and also subscribe to my channel. Turn on the notifications so you'll be alerted when I post new videos on this channel. And please remember that this video is for educational purposes only, and that if you have an urgent condition or pain, please consult your nearest emergency department. You may leave your comments, suggestions, or questions in the box below. Write down what you liked about this video and let me know. You may also contact me on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Thank you for watching. Bye!